The most basic field of existence in science, anyway, is referred to as the quantum field. And quantum fields permeate the entire universe, all of space-time, including our bodies. So our body is an expression of the quantum field. However, quantum fields can't be detected directly. They are measured or detected through what are called scattering experiments, absorption spectroscopy, emission spectroscopy, particle accelerators, etc. And they are real. Now, if you ask scientists, are these fields fundamental, or is there something beyond the field? Is there something that gives rise to the quantum field? And then you'll get iffy answers that some physicists believe that they may have emerged from the Big Bang. Others believe they may be more fundamental and have always existed. There's a concept called zero-point energy field, which is hypothetical, which gives rise to these fields, etc., etc. So fundamentally, we do not know the origin of quantum fields or if there's something more primordial to them. And yet those fields mysteriously give rise to the classical universe with people and rocks and stars and galaxies, Earth, sky, and everything. And they manifest as electromagnetic fields, strong and weak interactions. And so far, they cannot be reconciled with gravity. That's the challenge, the unified field challenge. So let's put quantum fields aside for a moment and go to the spiritual traditions of Vedanta, Shaivism, Yoga. And here you will come across a very different interpretation of fundamental reality, which has more to do with what we might call qualia fields. So qualia are qualities of awareness, qualities of experience, colors, shapes, forms, sounds, textures, smells, tastes, and even feelings and thoughts. They are more experiential. We experience qualia. Right now, as I'm speaking to you, you're experiencing a qualia called sound. And you're also experiencing qualia called colors. Even though there is no sound in your ears, no sound in your brain, and no colors in your brain, and nothing that we call an experience in your brain, it doesn't exist. So you are experiencing qualia as everyday reality. Colors, shapes, sounds, textures, forms, taste, smells, thoughts, feelings, emotions. That's our experience. We do not see fundamental particles, but we do experience qualias. And in the yogic tradition, these experiences that we call qualia are also referred to as vrittis, vrittis. Vrittis are fluctuations of consciousness that come from a consciousness field, which is more fundamental than the quantum field, because the quantum field is inferred and it's real, but it's not an experience. Qualia are experienced every day. And in fact, without qualia, there's no experience. And they too emerge from a qualia field, a field of consciousness. And in the yogic traditions and the tantric traditions, these are symbolized as Shiva and Shakti. And they are considered the two fundamental principles of the universe. Shiva is the formless, transcendent, formless, shapeless, infinite, transcendental consciousness that is at the heart of all modifications of consciousness that we call experience. And Shakti is the dynamic creative energy that brings forth all of creation. And they are inseparable, like the two sides of a coin, and their union is the source of all existence. The union of Shiva and Shakti. But remember, Shakti is just the fluctuation of the transcendent field of infinite possibilities that we call Shiva. And there are certain Shaktis that are identified as very important. Okay, so the first is Ananda Shakti. Ananda Shakti, remember, Shakti also means power of manifestation. So Ananda Shakti is the power of bliss. It is the pure, unadulterated joy that is inherent in all beings. It is often associated, again, metaphorically with the heart chakra, which is the seat of love and compassion. And by awakening Ananda Shakti, we can experience deep inner peace and unadulterated, unfiltered joy. That's the first Shakti. Then we have the second Shakti, which is called Gyan Shakti. It's traditionally described as the power of knowledge and wisdom. It is the ability to see things clearly without distortion or illusion. It's often associated with the third eye chakra, which is the seat of intuition. And by awakening Gyan Shakti, we gain a deeper understanding of ourselves and the world around us. And it's frequently referred to as spontaneous knowing. It's the knowing element in every experience. And when we have Gyan Shakti, we have access to intuition, a form of intelligence that is contextual, relational, holistic, doesn't have a windows orientation, eavesdropping on the cosmic mind. So that's the second Shakti. The third Shakti is called Ichha Shakti. Ichha means desire or intention, frequently also translated as the power of will. It is the ability to manifest our desires into reality. It is often associated with the throat chakra, which is the seat of expression. By awakening Ichha Shakti, we can take control of our lives and create the future we desire. And then there's Kriya Shakti. The Kriya Shakti is the power of action, you know, action without karmic consequences. It is the ability to take our ideas and turn them into reality. It is often associated with the root chakra, base of the spine, which is the seat of grounding and stability. By awakening Kriya Shakti, we move forward in our lives with determination, purpose, one-pointed intention. When there is the union of Shiva and Shakti, which is the ultimate goal of yogic and tantric practice, to unify or unite Shiva and Shakti within ourselves, and then there is so-called enlightenment. This is achieved through a variety of practices, and most importantly, the eight limbs of yoga, and that include everything from social emotional intelligence, yoga asanas, pranayama, pratyahara, interoceptive awareness, dharana, focused attention, dhyan, meditation, samadhi, which is transcendence and union of Shiva and Shakti. And again, this is symbolized by the lingam and yoni. Lingam represents Shiva, the formless transcendent consciousness, while the yoni represents Shakti, the dynamic creative energy. When the lingam and yoni are united, they create a powerful symbol for the union of the divine masculine and feminine principles. Now, is this practical in any way? And the answer is yes, it's practical, because unlike quantum particles we can't see, we can experience qualia, and by going to the source of all experience, which is vrittis, you know, fluctuations of consciousness, we can actually get to the source of all experience, pure consciousness. Pure consciousness, which is fluctuating as all these Shaktis. In Ananda Shakti, there is spontaneous joy. In Gyan Shakti, spontaneous knowing, no effort, It's the knowing element in every experience. It's the basis of all knowledge. It is knowingness itself, Gyan Shakti. And then Ichha Shakti, spontaneous fulfillment of desire through non-local correlation and synchronicity. And finally, what we call Kriya Shakti, spontaneous right action. What do we mean by that? The action that is evolutionary and in the direction of truth, goodness, harmony, beauty, love, compassion, joy, equanimity, and beyond the constructs of birth and death. So the qualia field can be experienced through yogic union. Its practical consequences are spontaneous joy, spontaneous knowing, spontaneous knowledge, spontaneous fulfillment of desire, synchronicity through awakening of non-local dormant potentials, and spontaneous right action. So that action has no karmic imprints. It only creates evolution in the direction of enlightenment. The day will come, I hope, when we can see that that consciousness and its fluctuations, the consciousness field and its fluctuations in qualia, are the basis of all knowing, and ultimately expressed symbolically only as the quantum field. I'd love to know your thoughts, and I am actually in the process of creating a course, an advanced meditation course, which includes some of the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali from the Vibhutis, which is about non-local dormant potential, so-called extrasensory perception, precognition, etc., etc., healing, love, compassion, all the things that are mentioned as the Siddhis, supernormal powers. And this course would be offered online, and I hope you'll join it, because it'll take the teaching of the Yoga Sutras and the Vibhutis and the so-called supernormal powers to a new level of understanding, combining qualia science and quantum science. Let me know what you think, and if you look forward to this course.